I told on the last video I will prepare one Excel sheet to calculate my red elevation in the vertical curve area. Look at that. I determined my VPC point and I determined, of course, my VPT point, my beginning of the vertical curve and end of the vertical curve. And I prepare one Excel sheet which is included to all cross sections in the my vertical curve area. Look at that. Here is my vertical curve beginning and here is my vertical curve endpoint. And look at that. In the inside area, I have 19 TO2, 20 B2, 21 blah blah blah, and H5. And I wrote all cross section name and I wrote all cross section name kilometers. Look at that. You can easily see your cross section kilometer. Look at that. 411, 414, 434, 52, 58, and 67, 83, 87, 90, and of course 1500, and TF2, and H5, of course it must be 500. And endpoint. What is the endpoint? VPT. VPT kilometers is that. And after after that, I must calculate absolute big G. What is the big G? My G1 is here and my G2 is here. Of course, it's absolute value. My G2, of course, it must be minus. And G1 equal minus this minus this. Of course, I calculated my ups, my G big G value that. And what is the X? X is distance from the beginning of the vertical curve. Look at that. Of course, I determined, I specified my vertical curve beginning and I measured all distance from the start point according to VPC. Look at that. First X value is 9.58 and second 12.02, 31, 75, 50. Of course it must be 50 because my vertical curve length, all length is 100. And secondly, 56, 64, 80, 85, 87, 97, of course 100. Yes. And I calculated all X value with comment of DAL, dim aligned. I measured all distance from the beginning on horizontal way, and I wrote all X distance and I calculate easily this formula. What is the formula? R equal to G1 time X. G1 times X. G1, what is the G1? G1 is here. And what is the value? Yes, this times G1. X times G1. X times G1. X times G1. You can easily calculate it, all R values. And secondly, I must calculate the y values. What is the y? Y is g divided by 2l times x square. Yes. What is y? Big G, absolute value. Big G is here. And what is the g divided by 2l? 0.06 divided by 200. Of course, it must be equal that. I found my equation. Equation is 0.000301 times x square. I gained that value from here, and only I must put to this x value into this equation. And look at that. Look at that. Sorry. this times 12 square, this times 31 square, this times 56 square. All y values calculated just like this, and I found all red elevations. How did I find that? Look at that. First VPC point red elevation is that. Of course, all other elevations must be calculated according to first point elevation. Look at that. 887.75 plus r minus y. Of course, this plus or minus situation can change your vertical curve type. Crest vertical curve, sec vertical curve, first grade is negative, second grade is positive, first grade or positive, second grade is positive. It can change according to your vertical curve situation, this minus or plus situation. And of course, you already know it. And I calculated all red elevation according to this first red elevation from VPC points elevation. And look at that. This plus r minus y. 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 Yes, I calculated all red elevation, and look at the reference elevation. What is the reference elevation? Reference elevation is my profile reference elevation. Distance from to bottom side of the my vertical my profile. Bottom side's elevation, my profile is 867. Yes, it's my reference elevation. What is the difference from this reference elevation? Look at that. This is the difference. It is the difference. Yes, difference. This minus 867. This minus 867. Of course, I calculated all elevation difference just like this, and it is the real elevation, this difference. It's in meters, but look at the scale. My profile vertical scale is 100, but horizontal scale 1000. Of course, I must times all elevation difference by 10. I must times all elevation difference by 10, and I gained all required distance on the vertical curve. Look at that. This times 10, and I will calculate all required distance just like this. It's too easy, and I am going to my vertical curve inside, and first point is 19. 19 is a must be 211 upside of the bottom side. Look at the value. It's first point, of course. Look at that. Yes, 68.85. Yes, on the line. Look at that. And 66.72. Yes, 26.63. Yes, 28.75. 21.85. And 0664, yes, 53.22, yes, 39, 25, 23, 79, and 35, 19. Yes, and I calculated all distance from the bottom side of the vertical curve, which is the all vertical curve elevation. This is all vertical curve elevation, and you can see like just like this shape, and easily with spline fit and first point put F8 button, end point of to my vertical curve, and read to cursor to end point and tap the space. Yes, I created my vertical curve. Yes, that is my vertical curve. This vertical curve equation is this, of course. And go to the sample project. Where is the sample project? Sample project, and go to the here. This is a vertical curve midpoint, and copy that and paste it, and type your vertical curve midpoint kilometers. Of course, my midpoint kilometers is that, and my L value is 100, and my E is equal big G, absolute big G, times times L divided by 8. Look at that. Absolute G times L divided by 8. It's a formula. You know already that. You already know that. And I wrote all parameters of the my midpoint of the POI. Yes.